Brethren, I am a Pharisee. I'll base my reflection on this statement. You know that these were the men who were trying and had planned to accuse Paul and actually to put him in prison and possibly to kill him. And here is Paul before his opponents, opposes his enemies, and he addresses them and calls them brethren, which means brothers, sisters, which means we are the same. I don't know whether we can look at people who mean us harm, who plan against us, who hate us, and still call that enemy, so to say, sister, brother, brethren. And here is Paul standing before his enemies, and he addresses them with that word, familiar word, brethren. Let us try, and I pray that you see everyone who comes your way as a brethren, someone you have something in common with. We are all sons and daughters of God. Put away the challenges, the difficulties of that person. Bring everybody to that level of family, brethren. The next one is the word, I am a Pharisee. If you know the Gospels very well, you know that Jesus uses, or that always lashes out at the Pharisees. Don't be like the Pharisees. And here is somebody claiming he is a Pharisee. So to say, with pride, I am a Pharisee. And Jesus said we should not be Pharisees. So we see that even among Pharisees, Jesus can pick a soul for himself. Even among people we put away, we disregard, God can still raise up something beautiful. Look at the Pharisees in your life that you have ignored, people you have tagged. Those Pharisees, God can bring us some pause from them. What about you ourselves? Yes, maybe one or twice, or even more, we have behaved like people who were Pharisees. Hypocrites, don't write off yourself. Even in your Pharisaic behaviors, Jesus can bring you up like Paul. May he use every Pharisaic behaviors left in us and transform them into Paul's. Amen.